Treatment of developmental hip dysplasia. As I mentioned in previous video under the name congenital hip dislocation DDH, in developmental hip dysplasia, the acetabulum is more shallow than normal. As a result, the head of the femur does not fit into it well. The femoral head may slide partially out of the socket, subluxation. In severe cases, the head of the femur can slide completely out of the socket, dislocation. Early detection is vital. If DDH is left untreated, the hip joint develops abnormally and is more likely to require surgical correction. DDH can predispose a child to premature degenerative joint changes and painful osteoarthritis of the hip in the future. I have talked about the DDH symptoms and how it is diagnosed in the last video. Once a diagnosis of hip instability or dislocation has been established, treatment will be started with the aim of reducing the femoral head into the acetabular cavity so the latter is stimulated to grow normally. Classically, the treatment possibilities are divided according to the different age groups at the time of the diagnosis. Treatment for newborns up to 6 months of age. Treatment for babies younger than 6 months old is usually with an orthosis braces. Today, the orthosis most commonly used is Pavlik's harness. This orthosis provides simultaneous flexion and abduction of the hip joint through straps that join together relatively easily. Anterior straps flex the hips to 90 to 100 degrees flexion and prevent extension. Posterior straps prevent adduction of the hips. The treatment is based on the concept that if the reduced hip is kept positioned in flexion and slight abduction, the stimulus needed for normal development of the joint will be provided. The treatment with Pavlik requires normal muscle function for successful outcomes, so that it's contraindicated in teratologic hip dislocations and patients with spina bifida or spasticity. At first you should keep your baby in the harness all the time. After about 6 weeks, you will be able to take your baby out of the harness during the day. The baby will need to continue wearing the harness at night for about 6 more weeks. The harness is adjustable, so it can change as your baby grows. The child has to be examined frequently in order to evaluate whether the device has been applied correctly, usually once a week. It is very important to have your baby's legs positioned correctly. Do not try to adjust the harness yourself. The baby will also need regular ultrasounds every 4 to 6 weeks to follow development of the hip joint. 90% of the dislocated hips among children aged under 6 months could be successfully reduced and thereafter presented normal development through using this orthosis. If concentric reduction is not achieved over the first 2 to 3 weeks of use of the harness, this approach is abandoned to prevent Pavlik disease. Then the choice is to perform closed reduction and immobilization in a plaster cast brace. Complications specific to this treatment. Avascular necrosis, AVN. Seen with extreme abduction, greater than 60 degrees. This complication can be prevented via placement of abduction within safe zone. The safe zone or safe arc of motion is the range of abduction in which the hip maintains stability. It is calculated by assessing the maximum unforced abduction of the hip. Then, the hip is brought into adduction, and the degree of abduction with the hip dislocated is recorded. We take about 10 degrees from each end, resulting in a safe zone. Hips with a narrow zone of safety, less than 30 degrees, are less likely to be stable. A popular method of increasing the safe zone is to perform an abduction tenotomy. The abductor tenotomy theoretically would increase the maximum and unforced abduction and increase the safe zone. transient femoral nerve palsy, seen with hip hyperflexion. Pavlik disease. It is an erosion of the pelvis superior to the acetabulum and prevention of the development of the posterior wall of it, due to prolonged positioning of dislocated hip in flexion and abduction. It is important to discontinue the harness if the hip is not reduced by 3 to 4 weeks. Treatment between 6 months of age and walking age. Within this age range, most patients with DDH can be treated by means of closed reduction and immobilization in a plaster cast brace from the pelvis to the foot called spica cast under general anesthesia. Apply spica cast to immobilize in 100 degrees of hip flexion and 45 degrees of abduction with neutral rotation for 3 months. You have to change cast at 6 weeks. Avoid wide abduction because extreme abduction greater than 60 degrees is associated with avascular necrosis of the femoral head, AVN. So we can prevent the AVN via placement of abduction within safe zone that we have already explained. During the operation, percutaneous tenotomy of the hip adductor muscles may be necessary if the patient has an unstable safe zone, if excessive abduction is required to maintain the reduction. Confirm reduction with CT scan in spica cast with selective cuts to minimize radiation to the child. After the period of immobilization in the plaster cast brace, which will range from 2 to 3 months, the patient will progress to using an abduction orthosis for a further 2 to 3 months. When reduction through closed maneuvers cannot be achieved, open reduction is indicated. Treatment after reaching walking age. This requirement ought not to exist, since the ideal is to make the diagnosis well before this age. Nevertheless, for some children, there may be either diagnostic failure or failure of the consequent early treatment. Surgery is necessary with a procedure called open reduction for children older than 1.5 or if a closed reduction doesn't work. During surgery, the possible anatomic blocks to reduction will be removed, such as iliopsoas contracture, capsular constriction, inverted labrum, pulvinar, or hypertrophied ligamentum teres. Perform adductor tenotomy if the patient has an unstable safe zone, if excessive abduction is required to maintain the reduction. For this age group, along with the need to operations to perform complementary osteotomy in the acetabular region to improve the femoral head coverage, such as steel osteotomy, Daga osteotomy, Salter osteotomy, Pemberton osteotomy, among other types. I will talk later about the types of pelvic osteotomies and how to choose the optimal one for a patient with developmental hip dysplasia. After the age of 3 years, the femoral bone shortening to enable the joint reduction has to be taken into consideration. It facilitates reduction and decreases the risk of AVN by relieving the tension produced by the reduction of a previously dislocated hip. The child will be put into a hip spica cast in functional position of 30 degrees of flexion, 30 degrees of abduction and 30 degrees of internal rotation after surgery for 3 months. Often a child will then need a hip abduction brace to finish the healing process.